started out, I thought the whole company just had a 10% chance of success of surviving at all. So I find it quite surreal to be at this point and a great honor work with NASA to restore space flight, the orbital space flight to America.
Did you pitch to the Air Force Starship and the time on pitching that to NASA for it to be
No, at this point, we're basically keeping NASA and the Air Force informed regarding Starship. But the goals of Starship aren't necessarily really so. They're really off scale. They're on a different level, and so I think we need to make more progress with Starship in order to establish credibility with potential customers like NASA and the Air Force.
Thank you, guys.
In fact, I'm headed to Boca after this. I'm personally going to go work on Starship production later today.
Post a picture.
Elon, does a host deserve a dance today?
I can't set these expectations.
This is
kind of China. I'm not that good of a dancer. Work on my skills. I'm not your dancing puppet. Anyway, I tell you what, if after crew launch, 100%. Okay. So it's good to see everyone. I'm personally super fired up and excited, and I think it feels like you guys are too. The public, it's just going to be wonderful to get to astronauts back into orbit from American soil after almost a decade of not being able to do so. I think that's just super exciting. And like I said, with some technology advances, with respect to the abort system and other things, it will be on a booster that's reusable and a spacecraft that is reusable. The only part that isn't for Falcon Dragon is the upper stage in front. So there's still a very big percentage of reusability, I keep saying reusability. But really, this reusability is extremely fundamental to revolutionizing space, as it would be if it was an aircraft or cars or bicycles or horses, everything. We really want them to be reusable and then get the cost all the way down to simply reload propellant and fly again, just like an aircraft. And that's really what's going to open up space for the average person.
Are you in talks with NASA to make Crew Dragon reusable for humans?
We have been discussions with NASA about this for quite some time, and my understanding is NASA is very open to this. It's subject to obviously a lot of additional testing and verification.
What does it take to make it reusable for humans to fly again?
If Crew Dragon, especially even more than Dragon 1 or Cargo Dragon, is really designed with reusability in mind. So it has a much more the propulsion section is essentially waterproof, and even has bullet pumps in the propulsion section, which rings the pressurized section like a donut in the bottom. So we've really taken great steps to improve the reusability of Crew Dragon over Cargo Dragon, And so I think it's for sure way easier to reuse, but reusability of course is contingent upon support from NASA. But obviously the space shuttle orbiter was reusable, so NASA is familiar with the notion of reusability, but Crew Dragon is designed to be easily reusable. So with minimal refurbishment It's designed to be rapidly and almost completely reusable in the case of Crew Dragon, which would be great for lowering costs and improving launch rate. And then the booster, obviously, we've proved many times the booster is reusable. The only thing that's vexing is that upper stage, which is Falcon, which is not reusable. But unfortunately, we just don't have the payload capability to reuse the upper stage with Falcon. But with Starship, we've got an integrated upper stage and nose cone fairing that is designed to be fully reusable from the beginning, and has it's also quite a big vehicle, very big vehicle, actually. immobilizing made progress with Starship, then that NASA, DOD, and others will consider using that vehicle. But there will be, like I said, significant overlap between the heavy Crew Dragon and Starship to make sure Starship is really ready and accepted by our customers before we retire the existing fleet vehicles.
Do you have an updated timeline for perhaps on Starship when you expect to go to orbit for the first time?
I think we'll do a more comprehensive update on Starship in the future, but the I think we're making very good progress on the Raptor engine. We're so serial number 20 of the Raptor engine. We've completed production on that, and the production rate of Raptors is improving significantly, as well as we're making a number of design improvements to the Raptor engine. So each serial number has some design improvements, all the way up through, I think, probably serial number 50. So I think that Raptor is going extremely well. Primary structure is slower, and that's actually part of the reason I'm headed out to Brookville later today to just work on some of the primary structure engineering issues, especially the domes. When you are engaged in designing and building rockets, these things that seem perhaps trivial or not that important to the public or the uninitiated are actually incredibly difficult. Getting the domes right on the propellant tanks is one of the most difficult things. It's just a dome, like how hard can it be, but it's hard. And then getting the interface between the tank and the interstage or skirt that connects it to the booster, and then the interface from the tanks to the nose cone of fairing, the body flap control surfaces, the landing gear or landing legs, the heat shield, just general operations, and then of course for Starship being able to successfully achieve on-orbit refilling is extremely important. But actually, that's an example of where our work with docking with the space station is actually incredibly helpful. If you say one of the fundamental technologies is needed to go to Mars, orbital refilling is extremely important. That means you have to do precision docking in orbit. And our work with the space station and precision docking with the space station actually is one of the has helped us solve that very difficult problem of docking in orbit with precision reliably every time. But now we need to do it with two giant spaceships. It's like a space station docking to a space station. But I'm very excited about the potential of Starship, and I think it's going to be something that could really have a profound step change effect in humanity's ability to go beyond Earth. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.